Hi, welcome back. In today's video, we're going to talk about an experimental process for project direction with the aim of helping ensure that your project will deliver the goals that you intend. To illustrate what I mean by this, let's start out with a little scenario. Let's say you're in a race. So you're in a race against Usain Bolt, the fastest man in the world. Now, what if I told you that you could be guaranteed to absolutely win this race, get to the finish line first? I'd say, well, that's impossible. Usain's way, way faster than me. But what if we blindfolded Usain and then spun him around in circles so he didn't know which way he was facing, and then we started the race? I think then you would win the race and Usain would run off very quickly in a different direction. And that sounds a bit silly, but people do that with projects all the time. We come up with what we think is going to be the right answer, and we pursue that as fast as we can with as much effort as we can. For us engineers, that means we do a lot of detailed problem solving. So what we're trying to do here is develop a method to make sure that we're always problem solving in the right direction that will get us to our goal. The way we're going to do this is by using the experimental method. With the experimental method, what we've got is our hypothesis. We come up with an experiment to test that hypothesis, and we get some results, and we draw a conclusion from those results. So how does the experimental method apply to figuring out our project direction? In this case, our hypothesis is going to be what we think the problem to solve is, or it might be we have a hypothesis about the solution to that problem. In this scenario, our experiment is going to be interviewing someone or talking with the person that has the problem that we're trying to solve. And our results are going to be the person's answers to that question, and we're going to have to draw a conclusion from those answers. All right, let's consider an example. So for this example, let's say we're trying to figure out what we want to do for our career. And one of the things we're interested in is maybe being a separations engineer. Our hypothesis is that we won't want to become a separations engineer because they're highly paid, they have a lot of technical work to do, and they get to work on really applied real world projects. And so, you know, we could go through our engineering degree and train and then get a job as a separations engineer. That could be a long-term way to test this hypothesis. But much easier would be to go and interview a practicing separations engineer. So let's make that our experiment. Now, our experiment is going to be made up of a whole lot of little experiments. And so these are going to be the questions we ask. So what would be good questions to ask or to test these ideas? So for example, we could ask some broader questions like, what are your biggest challenges in your role? What are your biggest successes from your career? We could ask some more detailed questions like, what projects have you worked on? What do you do during the day? And this could give us some insights into the engineering job that we would never have unless we asked those questions or went and did that job ourselves. And then our results from these experiments are going to tell us what an engineer actually does in their role, what they see as their biggest challenges and their biggest successes. And that's going to give us some real information to help us make our decision of whether this career choice is right for us. We've got two things left to think about. One is, how can we do an effective experiment? And then where else could we use this technique? So let's cover some experimental tips here first. The first tip is going to be that we want to create an open question. So rather than lead our interviewee into an answer, we want to have an open question that they can come up with their own answer for, so that we have the most chance of learning something new and useful. So as an example, something like, what are the biggest challenges in your role? Versus something like, is it really hard to work on your water filtration project? So trying to make it an open question where possible. The second tip is to counteract the danger of open questions, which is to frame the conversation. So by framing the conversation, by saying, let's say, I want to talk about your work, your technical work as a separations engineer, then that already focuses the conversation down and lets them have some sort of scope for when they answer their open question. When we get some answers, we want to double check that we've understood correctly. And we can do this by repeating back the answer and saying, so what I'm understanding is blah, 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 blah. And then they can say yes, or they can say, no, actually what I meant was blah, blah, blah. That's a really good way to make sure you're getting and understanding the correct answers. And another key tip is two very important questions, which are, is there anyone else you think I should talk to? And what should I have asked you that I didn't? So those are a few tips to help your interviews go well. Now, looking at situations where we can apply this technique, one good one to practice is to find out what your classmates think is the hardest part of your course and see, you know, what they're struggling with compared to what you're struggling with. We could imagine applying this technique when we're starting a new project, and there we might be asking a client, or we might be asking our supervisor, so that we have a proper understanding of what the overall problem we're trying to solve actually is. We might apply this technique when we're developing a new product to make sure that the product we're developing is actually useful for the people that we're developing it for. In fact, in general, this technique is really useful anytime where we would be doing a lot of dedicated technical work, and we can make sure we're doing that work in the right direction by having a conversation beforehand. So good luck, and I hope this helps you with your engineering career.